He has delivered us from the power of darkness. So darkness has power. But he has delivered us from that power. Amen.
Amen.
And has conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of his love, in whom we have redemption. Through his blood we have redemption. Through his blood we have forgiveness of sin. And this Jesus, he is the image of the invisible God. He's the firstborn over all creations. Now this is where our special attention is required. From verse 16. For by him, how many things were created? What things that are in heaven and that are on earth, whether they are visible, whether they are invisible, whether they are thrones, whether they are dominions, or principalities, or powers. All things were created through him and for him. And he is before how many things?
All things.
And in him how many things consist?
All things.
And he is the head of the body, which is the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead. That in how many things?
All
he may have what?
Preeminence.
In how many things will Jesus have preeminence?
All things.
All things. All, in all circumstances, in all situations, Jesus must have what?
Preeminence
in all things. Remember, he satisfied all the conditions. That's why he said in John 19:30, he said, it is finished. Praise God. He said, it is what?
Finished.
It is finished. There is nothing to do that I have not done. It is finished. He satisfied the conditions so that he should have preeminence in all things. Jump to 20. And by Jesus, to reconcile how many things?
All things.
So when we are sending you out, now, how many things are you supposed to reconcile?
All things.
Why will you reconcile all things? Praise God. Reconcile all things. Go! There will be commission. Reconcile all things. He paid the price. There is nothing any person will have as a problem on the earth that you cannot reconcile. Jesus paid the price to have preeminence in all things. That's why when nobody could prevail, in Revelation 5, he prevailed. Okay? He prevailed. He took the scroll. He broke the seven seals. Nobody showed up. Everybody say all things.
All things.
Say all things again.
All things.
Bible says in verse 21, and by him to reconcile all things to himself. Whether there are things on the earth, your authority should get there, or things in heaven, because he has made peace through the blood of his what?
Through
the blood of his cross. Now, let's count from verse 16. Let's count how many times we saw the expression of all things. Let's count from verse 16. One, for by him all things were created. Okay? The same verse 16. A little down. All things were created through him. How many now?
Two.
Get to verse 17. And he is before how many things?
All.
That's number 3. And in him, all things. That's how many?
Four.
Right? Jump to 18. Towards the end. From that in all things, he will have preeminence. That's number what?
Five.
Jump to 20. And by him to reconcile how many things?
All.
So how many now?
Six.
Is six now, from verse 16 to 20. In those four or five verses, we saw the expression of all things, six times. All things, all things, all things. Listen, let me make a distinction for you. Look at Verse 21. Everybody read verse 21. One to go.
And
you who was where at the end. Enemies in your mind by wicked works. Yet now he has. Now, listen, everybody, listen. You need to make this distinction. Now, from verse 16 to 20, Paul was discussing all things. It was only in verse 21 he began to talk about "and you." He began to talk about the Colossian church and you. I don't know whether you're getting it. You know, our gospel has always been gospel of human beings. But there is something that I need you to know, and it will bring fire in your bones. Well, we think the gospel that Jesus only came to die for human beings. God didn't discuss human beings from verse 16 of Colossians chapter 1. He was discussing all things. Emphasis is all things. Jesus didn't come to die for only human beings. He came to reconcile how many things?
All things.
So, you see, this is my dress. The money you are paid.
All things.
The car you enter.
All things.
The animals you are rearing.
All things.
That's why Jesus. The land.
All things.
Every family you enter.
All things.
People say all things.
All things.
So nothing should escape your priesthood.
Yes.
Did you hear me?
Yes, sir.
It will not be good for somebody to be sleeping at this point. We have come to the priesthood of all things. We have come now to the priesthood of all things. Somebody read 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 21. Somebody, quickly. 1 Corinthians chapter 3.
Verse 21.
Yes. I'll start from 20. Read it aloud.
And again, the Lord knows the thoughts and reasoning of the wise and recognize how futile they are. So let no one exalt proudly concerning men, for all things are yours.
No, what happened? Did you hear it? Okay. Sister, we need to read it again. I think you have another version.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
I thought you had another version. Yes. Okay, who wants No. Even her own captures it.
Okay.
Alright, but let's read New King James. Somebody read, okay, primary New King James.
From 20. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise and they are futile. Therefore, let no one boast in men.
Let no one boast in men.
For all things are yours.
How many things are yours?
Yes.
Are you getting something tonight?
Yes.
How many things are yours?
Yes.
Jesus died for all things. And now, Paul was saying to the Corinthian believers, all things are yours. Why are you boasting in men? Because in that church in Corinth, they have four parties. This one said we belong to Paul. This one said we belong to Apollos. This one said we belong to Cephas. Then there was an original Jesus party. Four parties in one church. Quarreling, strife. People that Jesus have procured access to all things. All things. Is it land? Is it animal? Is it business? Is it market? Whatever it is, even if it's a chair, whatever it is, all things. That's what Jesus died for. The gospel we are called to preach, the gospel of all things. All things have to be reconciled. All things. Nothing should escape us. Now, it does not continue. Everybody listen.
Question 2. Therefore, let no one boast in men, for all things are yours. Whether Paul or Apollos.
Whether Paul or Apollos.
Or Cephas.
Or Cephas.
Or the world.
Or the world.
Or life.
Or life. So you're a commissioner of life.
Or death.
Oh, you can give death to things. You can give life to things. Go ahead.
Or things present.
Or is it the things present now? Now in Port Harcourt. Those things present now in Nigeria. Present in your community. Or in any family. Present things. You can control it. You have a say. You have authority over it. Continue.
Or things to come.
Or things to come, future things. Things that are in the future concerning Nigeria, in the future concerning that family, concerning your friend.
All are yours.
Or concerning your children. All are
yours.
That's the kind of authority you have. That's the kind of authority we have. And we are all most times sitting in the church asking the land, please, can I put my leg? When you have been commissioned to be a priest over all things. God wants an army out of the church. When will you manifest? When will you be stirred up to confront things? Are yours. Your priesthood is not a priesthood over, you know, what any particular thing. It's a priesthood over everything. Somebody say priesthood over all things.
Priesthood over
all things. Somebody say priesthood of all things.
Priesthood of all things.
That's what I have.
That's what I have.
That's what I have received.
That's what I have received.
I can do all things.
I can
minister to all things. Amen.
Amen.
Priesthood of all. I tell you a story. I finish with a story. A true story. This is a testimony that was shared in one of these ICCC conferences, International Christian Chamber of Commerce conferences. A man, from Sweden, Ralph, was sharing this testimony. He's a farmer. He rears cows. You know, like the way we do it here, but cows that have pens, you know, you push them in, you lock. They have access to water, to feed, and all. So when he learned this thing, that Jesus died for all things, you know, all things are supposed to be reconciled by his death, and by all the things he procured. So he began to practice it in his farm. He would open the door, you know, to where these animals are. And when they hear the clinging of the door, their ears would tilt towards his side. And he would open his Bible and read his Bible to his animals. Oh, yeah! He understood it. You know, this thing I'm saying now. Do you know people can understand it differently? Yes. People can understand it differently. They begin to minister to their womb, minister to their land, minister to their children with understanding. That is all things. That's what Jesus came to do. He's not small. There's nothing that escapes his death and suffering. And that's the priesthood he has handed over to us. Anybody who limits himself is not God that limited you. There is nothing you cannot pray for. You can minister life, didn't you hear it? Because those Corinthian brethren, they were wasting time in the church, quarreling. Strife. Even common Holy Communion, they didn't know how to take Holy Communion. Those who came early will finish everything and leave. Those who come late will not find anything. That was the church. Very childish church. church that Paul met in Corinth. There was nothing that they were not into. They were boasting against one another, going, taking one another to court. You have read it. So much so that once Paul said, listen, now that people are behaving like a bunch of school children, next time I'm coming, I'll come with a vocal. That's his church, he told. Why are you wasting away when all things are yours? Life is yours. You can give life to dead things. Things to come, they belong to you to manipulate. Things present, you can determine it. Look at the enormity of power that Jesus has given you, and you are sitting idle doing nothing already. So he said, stop this thing. All things are yours. Go and control all things. Go and control all things. In your neighborhood, control all things. Be the strongest person in that place. Control everything in that neighborhood, in that estate. Wake up! Jesus has died and resurrected. Wake up! Go and enforce the benefits of his suffering. Let the dividend, let people receive the dividend of what Jesus asked for. Go and distribute his goodies. Minister to people, bless their lives. There is something in you to give. So he began to read the Bible to these animals. And it was a constant thing. He would just come read the scripture. You know, the words that I speak to you, they are what?
Life.
Spirit and life. So he would read the word of God to them. And they would till their ears and listen. You know, but as a human being, after some time, he slacked. But before he slacked, it was discovered that when they go for exhibitions, his cows will win the prize in all the categories. So much so that a university decided to institute an investigation. They said, what is it that this man is doing differently? So they sent people and they investigated, you know, white people now. They said that he buys his feed where others buy. Okay? That we didn't find anything. The only thing that he has a queer habit of reading Bible to animals. So that's the only thing he does. But after some time, he slacked. He wasn't doing it. And one of the animals began to trouble, began to be rebellious, spoiling some gadgets and machines in the farm. So one day, he picked up his Bible, started again. He went. This time around, that particular cow was in trouble, you know, with chain that has intertwined the two legs. He was there in pain. He wanted to go and release it because he stopped. Don't touch it. Go ahead and first read the Bible. He finished proclaiming the Bible, reading the Bible. And God said, go lay hands on that animal. He laid hands. That animal, you know, slept. Woke up after 3 hours and became the best animal in the farm. All things are yours. All things are yours. All things are yours. To control. Praise God. So please, the purpose of this teaching is that God has commissioned us to go. And I couldn't send you out without arming you with tools. What I've given you tonight for this early morning, they are tools for ministry. See, as you and I are, in fact, I remember just flying and coming into one meeting and they gave me the microphone. By the time I was done, one man called me and said, how do you do this thing? How do you do this thing? He said, immediately you took the microphone, the whole thing changed. I said, but we carry something. We carry something, and it's not us doing it. I said, then I took that microphone. God was telling me what to do. Is it my business? I carry this thing, he's telling me what to do. He tells you who to call, what to do, this and that, that and that. So we must not keep quiet. There's something we carry. Jesus is in us, the ancient of days. So, this is where we are now. Please, I beg us, all of us, we are candidates of these things. Let's lay down our lives. Our people need to receive ministry. we are called to be a prophetic generation, to